Keisha, thank you. Deputies say four children were living in a home infested with roaches. Now two adults facing charges. News 4's Mike McCormick is live and local at the Spartanburg County Sheriff's Office. And Mike, first and foremost, what happened to the kids?
Well, Nigel, deputies put them in the care of their grandparents. As for the house that the children were living in, one deputy said the conditions there were the worst he'd seen in his 11-year career.
I'll just be thankful when they are out of my home because they have really made a mess out of a beautiful house.
William McBee says he owns this home along Goldmine Road, but he's been renting it to Samantha Burgess and Corey Dunn.
I beg them to keep the place cleaned up, and I'm always asking them to clean up a mess around here.
Spartanburg County deputies say a call about a domestic disturbance between Burgess and Dunn brought them here on Monday. According to an incident report, deputies found trash, dirty dishes all over, and roaches everywhere. A deputy says he moved a blanket one of the children was sleeping under and 30 roaches scattered out from underneath it. Plus, deputies say what little food was there looked old.
There has never been a bug in this house, man. This is my grandma's home, you know, and it's like, they've just totally trashed the place. You know, it's just nasty. There's no way a child should be living here. You know what I mean?
Deputies say there were actually four children living here, ages 1, 2, 5, and 7. Now Burgess and Dunn are each charged with four counts of child neglect.
But I really hate it for the children because they got four beautiful children.
McBee says his next step is evicting the couple.
You can just imagine what I'm going to be dealing with on the inside of the house and what those poor children have been living in. That's the sad part, the children living in that.
And tonight, Samantha Burgess and Corey Dunn are out on bond. We went back by the house this afternoon, and Samantha Burgess told us they had no comment. Mike McCormick, WIFF News 4.